Shalom, shalom. This is Brother Yuwana Don. Father, I don't want to come at you in the lesson through the Spirit and power of Yahweh Shema Shah. First and foremost, as always, I want to start by giving all praises and glorifications to Yahweh, Ba'ashem, Yahweh Shah, Ba'ashem, HaKakudash, the monster apostles and elders, a great millstone, well, peace, love, and salutations to the hopeful elect. We got four corners of the earth preaching his word and truth and sincerity. Shalom, all right? And as you see the title, as I check the feed real quick, give me a second. Okay, you check something real quick. Okay. It's entitled All These Nations Abandoning the Dollar Will Lead to the MOTD. Okay, turning down so it won't echo. So hey, this is what's happening, man. You know, I got an article from the latest person that is talking about abandoning the dollar, and it's from the French president, Emmanuel Macron, and I'm getting this article, okay, because he's the latest one to do it, and I believe France is a part of NATO, if I'm not mistaken, you know, and it's they're an ally of the U.S. too, so this is the beginning too of these other nations hating the whore, man. Okay, so this is from Bitcoin.com. I'm gonna read some of it. I'm not read all of it. Okay, if you brothers and sisters want to check it out, just go to Bitcoin.com and type in French President Emmanuel Macron. You're going to read more, because I'm not going to read all of it. Okay, so it's entitled French President Emmanuel Macron states Europe must reduce its dependence on the U.S. dollar vassals. Okay, let me see. I want to look up that word vassal, see what that's talking about. So I got that app on my phone. Matter of fact, I'll just go to the bear with me real quick. I just want to look up this word vassal to avoid vassals. If any of you brothers or sisters know, I mean, any of you brothers know that what that means, just post it. Let me see. It says, I've looked it up. It says a holder of a land of by feudal tenure, which is monetary on conditions of homage and allegiance. Okay, it says a person or country in a subordinate position to another. So basically being held hostage, you know, basically being held hostage under America's hegemony regarding the U.S. dollar, and they want to pull away from that. All right, it's pretty much what it's saying, I believe, in the spirit. You know, so France wants to back away from the U.S. dollar too. Okay, well, right along with Iran, Saudi Arabia, which Saudi Arabia was a basically a foreign. Okay, let me turn this down. It's a lot. You know, Saudi Arabia was a former ally, like I said, of Babylon, and now they are ditching the dollar, man. We know China, Russia, you know, all these other nations, they're ditching the dollar, man. So the American dollar is pretty much done. And that's making way for what? The MOTB, okay? The mark of the beast, the CHIP, okay? The Karagma, okay? And yes, this is another one of my weekly MOTB videos, okay? So I'm going into the MOTB. All right, so I'm getting into this article. It says, let me see. It says, Emmanuel Macron believes Europe should remain autonomous regarding U.S. and China. Let me see. Oh, yeah, because he met with the Chinese president on this matter. Okay, it says, French President Emmanuel Macron recently revealed his stance on the current geopolitical and macroeconomic issues Europe is facing, standing in the middle of the Russia-Ukraine war and a possible Taiwan conflict, which that's beefing up as we speak. All right, you got those ships surrounding Taiwan, okay? And yesterday, China was like, they ready to go, man. They ready to go to war after those drills. All right, so this is only going to further lead to the already damaged collapse of the U.S. economy even further. Okay, when China goes to war, you pretty much wrap it up, man, because most of our imports and exports come from China. Okay, and you know, America, if they invade Taiwan, America gonna slap sanctions too, and that's gonna further damage, all right, the already damaged economy, man, pretty much. All right, so it says, it reads on and says, at his return from a three-day visit to China, where he met with Chinese President Xi Jinping, Macron stated that Europe commonly gets caught in third-party affairs that affect its possibilities of developing strategic anonymity, if I'm pronouncing it right. It says, Macron also noted that this behavior of the economic union bloc is reducing it to be considered mere backers of U.S. on this, he told Politico. All right, so they basically want to back away from that dollar, man. Okay, let me see. Matter of fact, let me read on down, because I think it gets actually into it about them backing away from the dollar. Okay, this part is titled Avoiding Vassal Status by Reducing Dependence on the U.S. Dollar. It says Macron also stated that Europe had become dependent on the U.S. See that? They become dependent on the U.S. So they want to get their own independence, man. All right? Basically, they want to back away from that dollar. And this is trouble for the U.S. Okay, you had, a couple weeks ago, the Kenyan president, that Hamite was basically saying, got to do what you got to do, because the dollar is going to be ditched. All right, they ditching the dollar over there in Africa, man. Okay, so you might want to switch. You might want to adjust. All right, into get into a new currency, man. Okay, which that new currency is going to be the MOTD. All right, that's going to be the final solution. All right, or the end all be all to this current, all right, debacle of the dollar, man, so to speak, man. This collapse of the dollar, all right, which all these nations, they want to, Shalom, all the argument, I'll fall from 2 million. All these nations, they want to back away from the dollar anyway. They want to back away from using fiat currency. All eventually, everybody's going to be forced to take that MOTB. Pursuing the revelation of the 13th chapter. Okay, so it says again, it says Macron also stated that Europe had become dependent on the U.S. on their energy and military front, proposing to boost the development of European alternatives. Macron also criticized the dependence that the bloc has on the U.S. dollar, explaining it might hurt them in the future. Okay, because the U.S. dollar, it has no value, man. You know, and all these nations, they see it. So that's why a lot of these nations, they're going to back away from the dollar. All right. They're going to more and more going to get hemmed to that the dollar has no value. It's not backed by nothing. Because remember, in the 1970s, they did away with the gold standard, man. Okay. Which that was basically set up anyway, you know, the spirit. Because they wanted to set up a Federal Reserve System where, they can pretty much, you know, control the people, man, you know, create debt, you know, on means of control by debt, man, you know, because the dollar's not backed by any tangible substance, man, as gold and silver. Okay, so it's purposely done, man. The Federal Reserve is purposely set up for that very fact, so they can crash this current system and bring in that new one that they've been desiring, that they've been salivating, okay, which is that MOTB, okay, the C here, which they plan to put in everybody, that device, that Karagma, they plan to put in everybody, okay, real soon, okay. So let me read this. It says, on how this dependence might affect Europe, Macron declared, that says while European countries have not been targeted by U.S. dollar centric sanctions, at least not yet, right? Because they're backing away. They're backing away from the dollar and the petrodollar, okay? Which that really does damage, okay? And another thing too, why they not keeping the same energy with these other countries that they did with Muammar Gaddafi? You seen what they did to him years ago? They made a so-called example out of him, right? But why ain't keeping that same energy with these other nations like China and Russia, the BRICS nations basically, and these other nations that's even their own allies that's backing away from the dollar? Like, hey, I'm reading it with Macron, man, you know, and these other European countries, they're gonna be backing away too, all right? And hey, the dollar's already basically collapsed, man. So we just waiting for that big one, okay? That major false flag that Esau is planning, all right, to really usher this in, man. Okay, so I'm reading this part again. It says, while European countries have not been targeted by U.S. dollar-centric sanctions, European companies often complain that they can't conduct business with sanctioned countries and entities due to the risk of being targeted by secondary sanctions. China, Russia, and other countries of the BRICS bloc are currently working on developing alternatives, you know, other means of currency, man. All right, because they're talking about developing a new world order. Okay, China and Russia, which ultimately is going to bring in, you know, the ultimate new world order, which they want to control the, because this is all game, man. They want to control the entire world based on the MOTB, the Hour of Temptation. All right, and that's vastly approaching. It says, I'm reading this again. It says China, Russia, and other countries of the BRICS bloc are currently working on developing alternatives to the use of the U.S. dollar by conducting these activities. Right. We know they're backing away. All right. It says President Xi had made calls to the European bloc before asking it to stand against hegemonies. Yeah, the hegemony. of the U.S., man, the policies of the U.S. that they push throughout the whole entire planet, man, the whole entire world, okay? Basically, their status quo, basically their philosophies and policies they want to back away from, okay? Because basically, the U.S. was looked at as the beacon of light, but these countries, they don't respect America anymore, and they are drawing away from America because they've seen America. Yeah, Khan, hey, that's spirit. Babylon, the big bully, losing his grip, right? Because Babylon has been a bully, man. All right? America has been a big bully for years to these other nations. They get tired of it, okay? They see, they're taking advantage by seeing that the U.S. dollar is constantly weakening and devaluating, okay? And now they seizing their opportunity, okay, to come up with their own means of economic survival, so to speak, okay? So it said, it reads on, it says, unilateralism and attempts to decouple economies or severe supply chains in a call against adopting or supporting these sanctions, okay? So, let me see. That's all I'm gonna read right there. That's probably pretty much it. But yeah, man, France is the latest country to back away, man. And more countries gonna start backing away from the U.S. dollar. All right. So I'm gonna get a scripture. I'm gonna start with a scripture. I don't plan on making this lesson too long. All right. I'm gonna start with Isaiah 36 and verse 6, because a lot of you're gonna take that MOTB, man. A lot of you especially Israelites, because you already trust in Egypt. Okay, you already trust in Egypt, man. So it ain't easy. I mean, it ain't hard. It's a lot. It ain't hard for the so-called white man, okay, to get you to take that seat here. But a lot of you took the juice, so hey, you right for the picking for the Quran, man. So Let me read it. This is Isaiah 36 and 6. It says, "Lo, thou trusteth in the staff of this broken reed on Egypt, whereon if a man lean," right? It's a broken reed, man. It's a broken system, man. Y'all still trusting this shithole, man. Okay, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, you still trust in America. You still trust in Babylon, all right, the great. All right, which Babylon the great is about to fall, man. Pursuing to Revelation, the 18th chapter. Y'all trusting this bullshit, man. All right, but that's going to be to your downfall, all right? Because, hey, we've been telling you for years, America's going to be destroyed. If you take that Quran, all right, you're going to be destroyed right along with it. You're going to be in that lake of fire, because America's going to be a big lake of fire, man, real soon. All right, the Most High is about to make an example out of this place, just like he did Sodom and Gomorrah, which America is modern-day Sodom and Gomorrah. All right, it's going to get the ultimate judgment, okay? A judgment that's unprecedented, man, all right? So it reads on. Let me start from the top one more time. It says, "Lo, thou trustest in the staff of this broken reed on Egypt, whereon if a man lean, it will go into his hand and pierce it." So it is Pharaoh, king of Egypt, to all that trust in him. And the modern day Pharaoh is a so-called white man. Like it says, it will go into his hand and pierce it. All right, so allude to the RFID microchip, man. Okay, because a lot of people, backs are going to be against the wall when the banks collapse. Ultimately, when the economy collapse, okay, when all hell breaks loose, their backs are going to be against the wall, and the only alternative, all right, for these people out here is going to be take that C-hip, man. Okay, because they already trust in this broken system. They already trust in America, man, because that's why so-called white man has FEMA camps, man. Anytime there's a natural disaster, what called FEMA, right? That conditioning to trust in FEMA, to trust in the so-called white man, is conditioning these idiots out here to trust in them every time there's a natural disaster, which a lot of these natural disasters is still by the Most High, but a lot of them nowadays are done by heart, man. And the so-called white man is the devil. He knows what the fuck he's doing, okay? Because he's the devil, man. All right, that's why he's the devil. And I'm gonna get some comment, some scriptures off the comment board, because I got my other phone. All right, let me see what we got. You can go to Revelations, the 13th chapter. Okay, matter of fact, before we go there, let's stay in Isaiah. We're going to go to Isaiah 31 and 1. It says, "Woe to them that go down to Egypt for help and stay on horses and trust in chariots." See, trusting in the wrong thing, though. You're not trusting in Yahweh Bashem El Shai. And I'm talking about you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man. You're not trusting in the Lord. You're trusting in this damn devil. You're trusting in the so-called fucking white man. Okay? It says, "Woe to them that go down to Egypt for help and to stay on horses and trust in chariots, because there are many, and in horsemen, because they are very strong, but they look not," see, "but they look not unto the Holy One of Israel, neither seek Yahweh by Shemal Shah." So people don't seek Yahweh by Shemal Shah. You're seeking this devil for help. You're seeking the devil for refuge, man, the so-called white man. You're not looking to your true power, man. So when that C-hip is pushed mandatorily on you people, okay, you're going to take it, man, with no questions asked, no questions, okay? Verse 2, it says, "Yet he also is wise and will bring evil and will not call back his words, but will rise against the house of the evildoers and against the help of them that work iniquity," right? And you people work iniquity, man. Okay, you already juiced into a wicked society. All right, so the ultimate form of selling out is taking the MOCB, and y'all gonna do it because you already sold out, basically, spiritually. Okay, a lot of you niggas already sold out spiritually to the society. Okay, so it ain't gonna be hard for you to take that MOCB, man. Okay, It ain't gonna be hard. So I'm gonna read verse 2 from the top again. It says, "Yet he also is wise and will bring evil, and will not call back his words." Right, because his word is a word don't come back into him void, like it says in matter of fact, I'm gonna get it real quick. Let's back that up. Isaiah 55. His words don't come back to him void, man. All right, this is Isaiah 55. And verse 11, it says, "So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void." See, for not for nothing, his words ain't going out for nothing. And the mouthpiece of the Most High is the prophets. All right, the prophets out there on the highways and byways preaching his word. His word's not going out void. You see these prophecies coming to pass. All right, and that means the Lord is not a liar, man. Everything, all right, including the MOTB, is going to come to pass, man. Okay? And we seeing it come to pass right before our eyes. And a lot of you camps that teach against this, you're going to have to have a lot of you're going to have a lot of questions answered, man. Okay? You're going to have to answer for that, man. When you see this MOTB made mandatory, okay, you're going to have to answer questions. Okay? So it says, "So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth, it shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper to the thing whereto I sent it." So the brothers are throughout the four corners of the earth preaching his word, okay, and let alone uploading videos on the internet. So there's no fucking excuse. There's no goddamn excuse, all right, for our people not to know that they're Israelites by now, man. But a lot of them, they still want to be fucking African and all this bullshit, Mexican, Cuban, all these fucking bywords that this damn devil put on, man. And they don't want to acknowledge that the children of the Most High, that they're Yasharal. So the hell with two-thirds, man. At the end of the day, man, they're going to get their judgment. Okay, so back in Isaiah 31, again, it says, "Yet he also is wise and will bring evil and will not call back his words. Right, but will rise against the house of the evildoers and against the help of them that work iniquity." Right, the help, you help the so-called white man further you tribes, you Israelites help the so-called white man further his wicked system, and you help it, you help keep it going. Okay, so a lot of you're going to be destroyed with the so-called white man, with these damn devils, man. Okay, at the end of the day, you're going to be destroyed with, since you want to join hand in hand with the enemy, you're going to be destroyed with the enemy, man. Okay? Verse 3, it says, "Now the Egyptians are men and not the Most High." All right? The Egyptians are men. The main Egyptian is these Edomites, man. Okay? It says, "And their horses flesh and not spirit. When the Lord shall stretch out his hand, both he that helpeth shall fail," see, or fall. So, yeah, you help the so-called white man, you're going to fall with the so-called white man. Okay? You're going to fail with the so-called white man if you help this damn devil. You want to be in league. You want to make covenants with this damn devil. You want to sell out, all right? Be an Uncle Tom. Be a Sambo. All right? What have you, man? You're going to fall with the damn devil. You're going to fall with America, too, when it's destroyed. Okay, it says, "When the Lord shall stretch out his hand, both he that helpeth shall fall, and he that is hopping shall fall down, and they all shall fall together." See? All right, though hands join in hand, the wicked shall not go unpunished. I'm going to get Stan Isaiah, the spirits in Isaiah today. Let me get the one real quick in Isaiah, precept real quick, Isaiah 15 and 13. No, 13 and 15 slide. This is Isaiah 13 and 15. It says, "Everyone that is found shall be thrust through," see? "And everyone that is joined unto them shall fall by the sword." And sword represents destruction. Y'all gonna fall by the missiles, man. Because remember, a lot of you gonna take that skaragma, and you gonna fall with America with the missiles, by the missiles. 200 million nuclear missiles y'all gonna fall, man. You tribes. Fuck the other thing. I ain't talking about that, man. I'm talking about you tribes, man. Okay? You wanna join hand in hand, you're gonna be thrust through, man. Okay? You're gonna be thrust. You're gonna be killed. You're gonna be smited, man. You're gonna be destroyed. And rightfully so. Okay? So it says, I'm back in Isaiah 31, and I was in verse 4. It says, for thus the Lord spoken unto me. Matter of fact, Yakan. For thus have the Lord spoken unto me, like as the lion and a young lion roaring on his prey, when a multitude of shepherds is called forth against him, he will not be afraid of their voice, nor abase himself. That's pretty much it. So let's go to the Revelations. Let's go to Revelations, man. Let's go to Revelations 18, and then we'll get Revelation 13 chapter. Okay, because remember, America's falling, man. Okay, you niggas gonna fall with it. Okay, because these nations, they backing away from the dollar. They're beginning to hate the whore. Showing the Revelation 17 and 16. Okay, I'm not gonna read all of it because there's a lot of meat. I'm just getting key points of Revelation 18, the 18th chapter. This is Revelation 18. Started at verse 1, it says, and after these things, I saw another angel come down from heaven, having great power, and the earth was lightened with his glory. And he cried mightily with a strong voice, saying, Babylon the great is fallen, and has become the habitation of devils, and the hold of every foul spirit, and in a cage of every unclean and hateful bird. For all the nations have drunk of the wine of the wrath of her fornication, and the kings of the earth have committed fornication with her. All right? So all these nations that come over here, you know, they committed fornication with Babylon the Great. And the ones of them that don't leave, they're going to be destroyed in Babylon. Okay? But a lot of these nations, a lot of them are headed back overseas because they see America that it's not that beacon of light after all. Okay? So they getting the fuck out of Dodge and the dollar's crumbling. All right? But the ones that remain over here, they're going to be destroyed by the missiles, man. All right? It says, let me see. Yeah, verse 3, it says, for all nations have drunk of the wine of the wrath of her fornication, and the kings of the earth have committed fornication with her, meaning adultery, spiritual, okay, adultery, all right? These women come over here and they get slutted out, you know, start wearing pants, they don't cover themselves, you know, start accepting LGBT feminism, you know, that's a main stronghold. These women that come over here, all right, get caught up in this stronghold, man. But the most high is bringing the so-called white man's strongholds down, man, through the spirit, man. And it reads on, it says, and the merchants of the earth are waxing rich through the abundance of her delicacy. And all these nations, they wax rich coming over here, man. All right? But now they're seeing that America is a big fucking joke. And America ain't in that beacon of light no more, like I was saying, man. Okay? And a lot of these nations, they waking up, getting help to America. All right, it's all a fallacy, man, pretty much. Verse 4, it says, and I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, because pursuing Amos, the 9th chapter, this is the sinful kingdom. All right, so we got to come out of her spiritually. It's not talking about actually getting a boat, okay, and selling from here, you know, going to another country. No, man, it's talking about spiritually, because we got to have the faith that the Most High deliver us when those missiles come, man. So if you actually take a boat or a plane out of here, okay? And because you're hemp, that America's gonna be destroyed. That shows you don't have no faith, man. Okay? And the Lord, hey, the scriptures say, without faith, it's impossible to please him, man. Okay? So it says, and I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues. And that ultimate plague, pursuant to Zechariah 14:12, is the missiles, man. And also mean not taking that sea hill, because there's a great men that died, okay, of old renowned men that died, not giving in to the policies of the evil. All right, I'm give a couple examples. The Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, and Abednego, the three children, okay, and had the Maccabees, man, okay, that didn't give in to Antiochus and his policies, man. Okay, so hey, like the scriptures say, strive for the truth unto death, and the Lord's gonna fight for us, man. Because we know in this day and time, some of us gonna die, but guess what? The dead in Yahweh Shah is gonna rise first, man. Okay, so we gotta believe that, all right? And we're not gonna receive those plagues if we do that, man. Which that ultimate plague, like I said, is the missiles. Verse 5, it says, for her sins have reached unto heaven, see? And the Most High have remembered her iniquity. So the Most High remembers all the iniquities of America. That's why he's bringing this bitch down. That's why he's putting the spirit on these other nations to back away from the U.S. dollar, which we know it's all by design, but, you know, it's all according to the program of Yahweh Shemal Shah. Okay? He's putting spirit on these nations. Okay? Which the elite won't, like I said, which the elite won't anyway. It's putting spirit on these nations to back away from that dollar. Okay? So basically, man, it's dollars, man. Dollars done, man. It's already crashed. It's just, all right, it's only a matter of time they need before they push their MOCB. Verse 6, it says, reward her even as she rewarded you, and double unto her, double according to her works in the cup which she hath filled. Fill to her double, right? It's gonna be double the punishment, all right, when it's all said and done. I'm gonna stop right there, all right. I'm about to close out, but I'm gonna get a couple more scriptures, all right. Matter of fact, I'm gonna get what I said. I'm gonna go ahead and get our temptation and revelations, and I'll probably end it off on. I'm going to end it off on Revelation 17 next. 17 and 16. So this is Revelations 3. 3 and 10. It says, because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation. Okay? Which shall come upon all the world, so them that dwell upon the earth. So the whole entire world is going to be faced with that MOTB. Push mandatory. All right, it's gonna seem like our back's gonna be against the wall, but we gotta remember we got Yahweh Bashanam Shah. That's the difference between us and these fucking idiots out here, man. Okay, we got a power to lean on. Okay, these people don't have shit but a so-called fucking white man. And what is that to lean on, man? That's death. Okay, you lean on him, that's death, because he's leading you to your fucking death, man. Okay, and that's the problem with our people. They don't have no fucking faith, man. All right, a lot of you women don't have no faith. That's why a lot of these women, they gonna lead their man to take the chip. They gonna lead them to the nearest concentration camp and say, babe, we gotta get the chip. We can't, you know, you can't work without taking the chip. You know, you can't do nothing. We got a family to feed. That's how they gonna get these niggas, man. Because a lot of you fucking bitch ass niggas, you follow your fucking woman, man. You know, you don't got no goddamn backbone. Okay, so in our temptation, y'all not gonna make it. Y'all already got a lot of weak ass niggas out here. All right, don't have no testicular fortitude. So they're gonna fall by the sword, man, when they take that chip, man. All right, so let's read again from the top. This is on Revelations 3 and 10. It says, because thou hast kept the word of my patience, okay, because we're required to suffer. Suffering means patience, man. Okay. Suffer for Yahweh Shah. He suffered. Yahweh Shah suffered. We gotta suffer, man. All right, till he destroys this damn place. It says, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which consists of what? The MOTD. All right, the RFIDC here. It says, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. Verse 11 says, behold, I come quickly. The Lord is coming quickly, man. We see it by the prophecies coming to fruition, speeding up. All right. It says, behold, I come quickly. Hold that fast which thou hast, which is knowledge, wisdom, understanding. And it reads on that no man take thy crown. So again, we can't fold to the opinions of this world. Okay, we gotta stay trusting in Yahweh Shemal Shai no matter what. No matter if we persecuted or what have you, man. No matter if we gotta starve for about 2-3 days, we gotta continue our trust in Yahweh Shemal Shai, man. Okay, and the Lord, remember the Lord's gonna fight for us, man, if we keep our trust in Yahweh Shemal Shai. Alright, because America's gonna be fucking destroyed real soon, man. And these people, they don't have no clue what's coming. Alright, you just had fucking Easter Sunday. You know, Jake all oblivious to what's going on. You know, nobody's talking about, like I said before, nobody's talking about World War III. You got a World War III brewing up, and here it is. These people are totally oblivious to what's going on, man. You got China about to invade of Taiwan, goddammit. You know, these people out here in a fucking comatose state, man. All they can worry about is the fucking NBA playoffs. All right? Like I said, Easter just passed. They're getting ready for fucking Mother's Day. Worry about these stupid-ass holidays, these folly days, man. Okay? That's why a lot of you people gonna die, man. A lot of you niggas, man, too, man. Especially niggas, man. Especially fucking niggas. So I'm gonna end it off on Revelations 17 and 16. Okay, it says, and the 10 horns which thou sawest upon the beast, all right, NATO and the EU, okay, America, you know, allies right now, but they're about to turn, NATO and EU about to turn on America, man, especially NATO. NATO's about to turn on America, man. Remember that that sabotage of the Nord Stream pipeline, okay, that's being questioned right now, which they're speculating America did it, which we believe they did, because remember Biden last year, he threatened to destroy the pipeline if Russia invaded Ukraine. What Russia did, they invaded Ukraine, right? So that leaves America, man. Process of elimination, America, man. They're the only corporate that can do that, because why would these other European nations destroy their own pipeline? That's stupid. Trying to point the finger, but no, man, they know exactly who did it, man. It was America, man, and that's why that's going to definitely lead to them hating this bitch, man, and shooting fire, as it's going to say. I'm gonna read on. It says, verse 16 says, and the 10 horns which thou sawest upon the beast, these shall hate the whore, okay, because NATO. And the EU and America all represents the beast. It says, these shall hate the whore, which is America. America's that whore, all right? And shall make her desolate and naked, and shall eat her flesh and burn her with fire. See? America's gonna be burned with fire, all right? And we can't wait, man. We can't wait for this bitch to be destroyed. We can't wait till America be wiped totally out, man. So get the fuck out of here. Lord willing, we part of the elect. Okay, you sincere sisters out there, part of the 1/3, we get the fuck out of here, all right, and establish our kingdom in righteousness, okay? Because that's our desire, man. We spiritually salivate on seeing America destroyed, man. Okay, instead of having these fucking nations enslaved, the so-called white man, especially on our fucking feet, man. Okay, we salivate on that. We that's like a wet dream to us, man. God damn it. So these nations, they're gonna shoot fire on this. They're gonna shoot their missiles on this place and burn them with fire, man. Because America has made a lot of enemies, man. America's made a lot of enemies. Okay? And they're gonna reap the consequences of that. All right, by the Most High putting the spirit on these nations to shoot their warheads over here and burn this bitch up, man. All right? Burn all you wicked ass motherfuckers too, man. All right, so with that, I'm gonna close out. Hey, Lord willing, this was edifying. I'm gonna sign off. saying again, all praises and glorifications goes to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shah, Bahasham, Bakakwadash, double honor to the apostles and elders that agree most on well, peace, love, salutation to the hopeful elect. Got the four corners of the earth preaches word and truth and it's sincere. Say shalom, call me out, shalom, and a Bible ball, my waffle, I'm a ball, shalom.